and today we are going to discuss about AVR Microcontroller Development Trainer Kit and its order code is 43557. So in this video we are going to discuss how it works.
So this is a AVI Microcontroller Development Trainer Kit. So here we are having breadboard. Then this is the DC power supply of plus 12 volt. So this is the plus 12 volt connection and this is the ground one. Then similarly we are having plus 5 volt DC power supply. Then minus 12 volt DC power supply. Then minus 5 volt DC power supply. Then these are the FRC connector ports for port B, port D, port C and port A. So we can connect the modules through these FRC connectors and this is the main power on off switch and this is the programmer section. Here we are having ATMEGA IC connection, IC base, then this is the RS232 connection, then here is a switch for keeping it to program or develop mode and the LED will indicate according to that. Then this is the USB connector for the programming and then this is the ATMEGA 8515 connection. So here you will, after doing the programming, here you can connect the IC and from the 2mm ports you can connect probes through these 2mm ports to the breadboard and on the breadboard you can design the circuit and you can perform the experiments accordingly. So from here you will connect the probes to the breadboard and you can perform the experiments accordingly. So now we will do the working on this kit. So firstly we have to install the software and the drivers. So for that, along with the kit we will supply a CD where you will find these folders. So 43557 CD material and you will find these folders inside that CD. So first is the E1, then the sample codes, then softwares and then tools. So firstly we have to open the softwares. So here we will find AVR Studio 4 setup and then we will find here AVR tool chain. So firstly we have to install the AVR Studio 4 setup. So this is the kind of interface you will find on your screen, then you have to select yes. After that you have to select next and then next, and that is how the AVR Studio 4 setup will done and you have to click on finish. Now you have to install AVR tool chain. Now again press yes. Then again you have to press next, then again next, so that is how the installation is done. So after installing the software, now we will install the drivers. So in this system I have already installed the drivers. So the installation driver procedure is explained in the manual and you can refer the manual for installing the drivers properly. So we will provide you the drivers along with this kit. So in the tools you will find the drivers. So from here you have to install the drivers. Then you can check it on the device manager. So after installing the drivers, you can check the driver in the device manager. So here we will select or we will open the device manager. So here I will open the device manager and now here library USB is shown here. So this is the indication that the drivers are installed properly, and now the system is detecting the AVR controller. So when you do the connection, so it will detect the library USB. So here you can see that right now I have connected the USB with the device. So when I remove this, you will not see this library USB in the device manager. Here you can see that, and when you will connect it, you will found that it is detecting the USB properly. So here you can see that now library USB is being detected. So that is how you can check whether the drivers are installed properly or not. So now after the successful installation of the drivers, now we will do the steps to program our microcontroller ATmega8515 using programming ISP. So firstly, we have to keep the power of the unit on, and we have to keep this SPDT switch at programming position, and this LED will glow. So this LED is indicating that it is in programming mode, and we have to connect the USB for doing the programming, and we have to connect this ATmega IC here in the programming section. So you have to place it like this, and you have to lock by using this. So that is how you have to prepare your kit for doing the programming. So now we will move to the software. So now in the software, we have to go to the tools. So here you will find the burning software. So we have to open it, and here we will find the software. So this is the program ISP. So that we need to open. So this is the interface which we get while opening the software. So now here we have to select the chip. So here you can see by default it is ATmega8515 is selected. So here you can see that by default the selection of chip is there. So if the USB does not detect your IC, then you have to select it through this option. So here you can see the different options of the IC selection. So here we have to select the ATmega8515. Then we have to go to the file, and we have to load flash. All the procedure is mentioned in the manual also. So in the manual you will notice all the procedure is explained in the manual. Step by step procedure is explained in the manual. So you can refer the manual for better understanding. So now we will load the file. So here you can see this is the hex file which we have to load. So we will select this hex file, and we will click on open. Then we have to click on read. So here you will notice that a message will pop up, and it is written that read ID is successful. So after that, we have to check all the boxes here. So we have to check the box of verify signature. So we have to off it. Then we have to select the chip erase, then blank erase, then program flash. And we have to unselect this program EEPROM. So all the check boxes you have to select according to the manual. Then on the right side also, at the EEPROM section here, Also, you have to check these check boxes. So we have to remove only this verify EPRO, and the other boxes are okay according to the manual. So you have to cross check all these from the manual, and you have to select the check boxes according to the manual. So after doing this, we have to click on auto to burn. So here you will see the burning is done. So after successfully burning, you will notice a message on your screen. So it is written that erase blank, write flash verify, flash write fuse. All these are verified and successfully done. So that is how you have to do the programming of your ATmega8515. So after the programming is done, now we will keep this switch to develop mode, and now we'll switch off the power supply of the trainer kit, and now we will take the IC ATmega8515 from programmer section to the connections section. So we will place the IC here. So firstly we have to open the IC base, and now we will close like this. So after placing the IC here, so now we will perform the experiment. So you can design any circuit on this breadboard. So we have already designed a circuit here, that is the elevator control module. So we have created a module, so I will show you the experiment of that module. You can design any of the circuit on this breadboard, and you can connect the ports of the ATmega8515 from here to the breadboard, and from the supply section you can give the supply, and from the connections port you can give the connections to the breadboard directly, and that is how your connections will work. Or if you are using a module, you can use this ports for connecting the FRC. So I have created a module, that is elevator control module. So I will connect through the FRC cable, and I will show you that experiment. So this is the elevator control module which we will use to perform the experiment. So I have created the circuit of elevator control module, and firstly I will connect this J1 FRC port to the port B like this, and now I will connect the J2 to this port A like this. So we have to connect the FRC while switching off the trainer kit. So after connecting the FRC to their respective ports, now we will switch on the main unit, and firstly we will press reset. So here you will see all the LEDs will glow at first time, and then you have to press reset for deleting all the previous data. So now here on the module you will see this is the power LED and this is the ground floor. So now I will explain you how this elevator control module is designed. So it is divided into two sections. This is the first section of inside. So inside is indicating that when the person is inside the elevator, or he or she is inside the lift. So this is the inside portion, and this is the outside portion. So this side is outside one and this is inside one. So outside is indicating that when he or she is outside the elevator or outside the lift. So these two are the different sections of the module. So now currently the lift is in ground floor, as it is indicating by the LEDs. So when a person calls the lift or elevator, to any of the floor. So here we are having first floor and second floor. So let's suppose a person who is standing or waiting outside the second floor. So he will press the button to go downward. So he will press this switch. So the person on the second floor who is outside the lift will press the switch of the second floor so that the lift arrives there at the second floor from ground floor. So the currently the lift is at ground floor. So the lift will move to the second floor. So this blinking of LED indicates that the lift is going from ground to second floor. So this LED blinking showing the time of the elevator which will be required to move from ground to second floor. So it will blink 10 times. So that is the delay time or the time taken by the lift or the elevator to come from ground to second floor. So after blinking of 10 times, it will be constant. So which indicates that the lift or the elevator reaches to the second floor. So here you can see now the blinking of LED stops. So it means that the lift reaches to the second floor and now the person can go inside the lift. So now this section will work. So now the person is inside the lift or the elevator. So now he can choose from second floor where he wants to go, to the first floor or the ground floor. So let's suppose we will wants to go to the first floor. So he will press switch 2. So now again this blinking of LED occurs, which indicates that the lift is coming from second floor to first floor. So now the person who is inside the lift is pressing the key which is first floor. So he wants to go to the first floor. So here you can see the lift is going. So this is the time taken by the lift to go from second floor to first floor. And after a certain interval of time, the blinking of LED stops, which indicates that the lift reaches to the first floor. So here you can see that now the first floor LEDs stops blinking and it is showing that the lift reaches to the first floor as the LEDs are blinking constantly. So now the LEDs are constantly blinking, so it indicates that the lift reaches to the first floor and now the person can move outside the lift. So now the person is on the first floor. So let's suppose another person who is calling the lift at the ground floor. So from outside he is calling the lift at the ground floor. So now the lift is moving from first floor to ground floor. And this blinking is the time taken by the lift to reaches from first floor to ground floor. And when the LEDs were constantly blinking, that shows that the lift reaches to the particular floor. So here you can see that the lift reaches to the ground floor and now the person moves inside the lift and now he will use this section. So he will select, let's suppose the person is selecting the second floor. So he wants to go to the second floor. So here you can see that the lift is going to the second floor. So after a certain interval of time, you can see that the lift reaches to the second floor. So that is how this elevator control module works. Similarly, you can design your particular modules and you can perform the experiment by using these ports. Or if you don't want to design the modules, if you want to build the circuit on the breadboard, you can directly build the circuit on the breadboard and you can do the connections from here to the breadboard directly. And you can use the power supply from this section and you can directly make the connections from this ATmega 8515 board to the breadboard and you can perform the experiments accordingly. You can also do the programming by using this RS232 connector. So that also you can do by using this AVR programmer module. So now let's see an experiment on the breadboard also. So I have created a connection on the breadboard by using this input dial and the LEDs and the resistance. So by using these I have created a circuit and now we have to do the connections. So firstly we will connect the PB0 from the ATmega 8515 to this first resistance like this, and now sequentially we have to connect these like PB1. Now we have to connect, so we will connect it, and now again we will connect PB2. Now we will connect PB3. Now we will connect PB4. Now we will connect PB5. Then we will connect PB6. Then we will connect PB7. So that is how the connection is done. And now we will connect the ground from any of the ground section. We can connect the ground directly. To here. So here on one end we have connected the ground. Now we will do the connections for the input. So we will connect A0 to the first one, then similarly A1 to the second, then we will connect A2 to third, then we will connect A3 to fourth like this, and now we will connect A4 to five like this, and then A5 I will connect it to six, and then last one I will connect it like this. So that is how the connection is done. So now after the connection is done, now we have to program our ATmega 8515 IC. So the program which is already there is the program that is used for the module elevator control. So now we have to again program this ATmega 8515 for this circuit. So we have to again place it in the programmer section. So here we have to place our ATmega8515 and we have to again program it. So we have connected the USB and now again we will move to the software for doing the programming. So you have to switch on the main unit and we have to keep this SPDT switch at program mode, and this LED will indicate that now it is in program mode. And now we will move to our software. So here you can see that now we have moved to our software section. So here we have to again doing the programming. So for that, firstly we have to verify all these boxes of the erase side and the auto side. So we have to check all these boxes, and after that we have to select the chip, and then we have to go to file, then load flash. The process will be similar as we have done in that earlier one. So now we will move to this folder and we will go to this and we will select the hex file and we will open it, and then we have to do the program. So after doing the program, we have to click on this auto, and the burning of the program will occur on the ATmega8515 IC. So after the programming is done, we will get the message here on the screen. So it will be displayed that it is successful. So now after the programming is done, we will move to our main unit. So now the programming is done. So we will off this SPDT switch from program mode to develop mode, and then we will remove our IC from the program section, and now we will keep it here. So firstly you have to switch off the main unit, and then you have to keep this IC here. So now after doing the program, we will remove the IC from programmer section to here, and then we have placed the IC and lock, and then we will switch on the main unit. So firstly we have to press this reset button so that the previous data get removed. So now these two LED were blinking. This shows that our program is running. So now when you will press this hex decimal keypad, so according to that you will see the changes on the LED. So it will show the binary output. So whatever configuration you are doing, you will see the changes according to that. Here you can see that. So here you can see the changes. So that is how you can perform the experiment on the breadboard also. So you can create your own modules and you can connect those modules through this FRC connectors, and if you want to draw the circuit on the breadboard, you can draw the circuit like this, and when you will doing the programming to the ATmega8515, after doing the programming you can place the IC here, and then for breadboard you can directly connect the ports from here, and for modules you have to connect the FRC. So you can use this FRC connectors. So that is how you can perform the experiments through modules and through breadboard also. So that's all the demonstration from my side. If you have any queries related to this kit, you can contact the Tesca Global website. You can find the link in the description. For more information, go through the manual. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, like, share and subscribe to our channel.